Hello. In this video, we will see how one can use Aigents graphs in order to study Ethereum transactions. We already know that using Aigents graphs, you can study graphs of news and explore information sources, dates, and news feeds in respect to your interests. But now we'll be see how we can use Aigents graphs for something more interesting. In our earlier version, it was possible to browse Ethereum graphs of any random accounts, but within close distance. You can see the account and nodes that are corresponding to current account, but just within short range. And you could also consider different time slices. You could see 1 month period, 1 week period. You can also filter nodes by connectivity, seeing more connected nodes, less connected nodes on the graphs, and you could use different time ranges. But now you can do more. Now you can use arbitrary range and explore graphs as far as you want. In order to do that, you can use right mouse click on the current Ethereum graphs, and you can specify the query. One parameter of the query is a network, so in the future we'll be able to use different networks for this kind of analytics. Right now we use only Ethereum. Another is what we call seed. So seed is a node which is used to start the search in the graph. So right now this node is a seed. Also you can specify period, number of days you want to search from today back in the past, and you can also specify the range. The range is amount of hops that you want to do from current node to other nodes. And finally, you can specify the limit of nodes you want to have retrieved from the entire graph, because if you retrieve 1 million nodes, your browser won't be able to render it. So we can extract only limited number of nodes. So let's start with this simple one, period 1, range 1, and we should be able to see something very similar to what we saw before. We just use different kind of styling. Styling is different, but information is the same. So let's start changing parameters. Let's start going in the past. So let's say we are interested about 2 days, not 1 day. So the graph query is executed, and now we are updating the system with information specific to a longer period. And let's consider 4 days. We should be getting more transactions. Of course, it takes longer. The more days you specify, the more complex graph query is, so you may need to wait. Okay, so but that was all with only range equals 1. So let's go back to period of 1 day, and let's specify range 2. Okay, so we see something interesting happening. We see more nodes involved. So we see nodes or further than a seed node are connected to the neighbors. Let's keep increasing the range. Let's say 3. Okay, we have even more nodes, and by the way, we can start playing with different graph parameters. We can specify node radius. We can change node radius to 10. Okay, we can specify, we can play with different ways of layout arrangements and get different distributions of the nodes. But let's try to go further. Let's try to go even further. Let's say we want range 4. Looks like we are not getting that much at this time because of the restriction of the nodes that we have. But let's now start improving the period. Increasing the period. So we are getting more information. If we increase the period, let's go further, 3 days. And let's try 4 days. Okay, so here is something that we see for 4 days. And let's now play with different ways of, and by the way, we can also increase the limit. Let's say we want to have 400 nodes to be rendered. Let them be smaller. Let's change the balance style. This direction. Well, probably we have too much. Let it be that. And let's say we want to change the arrangement. So we have top hierarchy nodes placed on the top. So right now, the layout of the nodes is computed based on the amount of cache each of the nodes on the graph is receiving. Like the node on the top is getting most of the cache within given graph, and the nodes in the middle has less cache, and the nodes at the very bottom are mostly paying. And we can do filtering on these nodes. So if I select the node, then I can filter the node, and I can also specify the range of the filtering. Like if the range is 1, then I can see only the nodes that are directly connected to the target node. If I increase the range, then I can see other nodes that are also connected through the neighbors. For this case, we don't have more connectivity, so let's remove the filter. Let's say, let's take another one. That's not connected much. Let's say another one. Well, not all of them are too connected. By the way, if we look at the nodes, we can also check the origins of these nodes. So let's go to Ethereum scanner. Okay, so that's some smart contract on the very top. So let's see what else we have. And that's okay, and that's some gambling site. And by the way, also what you can do, for example, if you're interested about environment of this site, what you can do, you can actually use menu to follow this node. So you can just dive into this node and see, right, another kind of graph. So this is graph is built with another seed. So we have changed the seed to the node of our interest. And let's now do some sort of layout of this. Let's make it arrange it vertically. Yeah, we have some other distribution. And the node at the very top is something different, I think. Oh, so that's famous CryptoKitty projects, which is receiving all the cache within given subgraph of the node. And by the way, you can differentiate different connections, like blue arrows are wallet to wallet transfers, or wallet to smart contract transfers, and green arrows are just arrows indicating pure calls to smart contracts without of any cash transferred. And you can use filters, like if you want to disable the calls being rendered, you can uncheck them. And if you can also see the, you can only see the calls to smart contracts, you can remove payments, and you will see only the smart contracts on the graph. And you can actually use any other layout options that present in Aigents Graphs framework. And you can apply different filtering options, like you can select the nodes, you can improve the number of ranges that you use to do the filtering. So that's kind of research you can do with the Aigents Graph since now. It is released, and it is available on top of the older Aigents graphs, but we'll see how we can integrate the new functionality in the Aigents user interface. Thank you, and stay in touch with the Aigents.